do you understand this code? Whoa. This is crazy. This is absolutely crazy. What's going on, guys? Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to Amigos Code. In this video, I want to show you that soon you won't need to write any tests. Literally, that's amazing, right? So you know that I'm a huge fan of testing, and sometimes people are confused in a sense that writing code to test my code, like, it doesn't make sense, right? And today I was playing with ChatGPT and I was like, can you write tests for this code? And I just found out that, oh boy, this is serious. Let me show you. Okie dokie. So in here, I'm within IntelliJ, and this source code right here is part of the brand new course that I've just released called Full Stack Professional, which is about 50 hours teaching you pretty much everything about full stack development. And also you learn about both Angular and React, depending on your preference, and also security, CI/CD, and all that good stuff. So here we have some code, and we want to see whether ChatGPT can give us the tests, because once we have the tests, then you know that with tests, it's mainly copying and pasting and then changing few things once we have the happy path. So here you can see that there's customer role mapper, we have a customer class and whatnot. So what we're going to do first is let's go to customer, and I'm going to take this right here. So this class, I'm going to paste into ChatGPT, because I want to feed ChatGPT with as much information about my application or the classes or the domain in order to write the correct tests. So let's move on to ChatGPT. So if I just paste, and then here I'm going to say, do you understand this code? Cool. So it says, yes, it understands. And now let's take the class that we want to test and then see whether it can write the test for it. So here, let's just take everything and then paste, and then say, can you write tests for the above class using JUnit 5 and Mockito? Let's just see whether it does the right thing. So here you can see that it has customer role mapper test, and it's actually using mocking, and it finished. Now in here, let's just take this code. And what we're going to do is, the ideal scenario is that we want to take the code, copy, and it should just work. So fingers crossed. If you enjoyed this content, take 2 seconds and smash that like button, as it helps the channel as well as the YouTube algorithm, so that we can keep on growing and providing you with awesome content like this. So let's just write the test for it, and let's paste everything. And obviously it doesn't, right? So here it's actually missing the package. That's fine. And wow, it looks like it did a good job, right? So let's now run the test and see whether it works. So let's just run the test. Whoa. This is crazy. This is absolutely crazy. Wow. So it gave us the test. The only thing that it missed was the package. But apart from that, just have a look. So it did the setup for us. It has one test, because this class only needs one test. All the mocking stuff. And because we gave it knowledge about our domain, it knows what the customer looks like. So this is awesome. So have a look. So the ID is 1. It also passed the ID inside of the role mapper. So this is unbelievably good. So this is beautiful, beautiful stuff. Now let's try and test something more complicated. So here, customer service. So here we have a bunch of classes. So what we want to do is, so it knows about the customer. So that's fine. So let's feed customer DTO, because this is part of basically few tests. And I think this is pretty much it. So this is a record. So command C, go back. And then here I'm going to paste that and then say, do you understand this Java record? So let's just see what it says. So yes, it understands the Java record. It has all the roles and whatnot. Very good. Now let's feed the class and see whether it can write a test for us. So back to the customer service class in here. So customer service, command A, command C, and in here, let's just paste. And then here I'm going to say, do you understand this code? So this is basically prompting, and I'm just trying to make sure that it understands what I'm giving it before I ask him the end result. So it knows basically what the class is all about, which is perfect. So now I'm going to say, cool. Can you write tests for this class using all the inputs I gave you? Use JUnit 5 and Mockito. Also, mock all dependencies. So this is important, right? So basically, I know exactly what the test should look like, but I don't want to write the test. So I'm just going to tell it what I want the test to look like. So mock all dependencies. So now let's just press enter. And it's basically giving me the test class. So this is beautiful. So I think this, we're going to have to say continue a couple of times because ChatGPT basically doesn't give you the full class if it's like too big, but that's fine. So let's just wait. But I see that it's doing really good stuff. So there we go. So this is what I was saying. So continue. So eventually we'll take all of this, copy and paste, and see how it works, right? So now it's just basically continuing. And you can see that it's giving me a bunch of tests. Now, obviously, like for us, we can write all of this stuff. But this is much faster, especially if you write, for example, an IntelliJ plugin that can just give you the test class. So let's just say continue. So this is the idea, right? So obviously you're not going to be using ChatGPT like this through the console, but if there's a plugin that we could just implement and have the tests for us, and all we have to do is just inspect and make sure that the tests are correct, change a few things here and there, and if we have all the edge cases covered and the code coverage looks good, then yeah, so it's a win, right? So cool. So now it finished. It actually got the last curly bracket in here, which is not a big deal. So let's just copy all of this. So we're going to start with the first one. So copy. I'm going to paste that within IntelliJ. So here, let's just create the class for customer service. So there we go. Paste. Go back in here and take the second code snippet, copy code, and then paste. So we're going to continue. And finally, the last blob. Basically take this, so copy, and we're going to paste. Cool. And then the last semicolon, and it's done. So obviously it has few things. I think here what it's missing is the package like before. Cool. Now let's basically see whether if we run these tests, whether they will work. So let's just run. Almost. So I think here as well, we have to remove gender. And that's because we didn't feed him with everything that he needs to know about, right? So we forgot the record. And in here, run. Oh my goodness. Everything worked apart from one test. And that's basically this one here. So I think he wanted a male. And we said female. Yes. Okay, cool. Do we need to change this to female? Right, let's just run the fail test for a second. And hooray, cool. So this is beautiful stuff. And to be honest, so one thing that I want to do is I want to run this with coverage. So yes, so here, run with coverage. And so we have the coverage. Now let's just go back into the class which has been tested, customer service, and let's see which lines it did actually test. It actually missed this line in here, but then we could actually test ourselves. But I think it did a pretty good job. And obviously you can see the potential of this. And as you know, like with ChatGPT, the more you give it, the more it knows, the more data we give it, the more it learns, the better it becomes. So the future looks really, really bright. And yeah, no need to write tests anymore. That's it. Hooray. If you enjoyed this video, smash that like button, comment down below, and let me know. Do you trust ChatGPT to write your unit tests? You can see that it can perform unit testing, mocking. We didn't try integration testing, but I'm pretty sure that it's capable of. This is pretty much it. Smash the like button. Let me know what you want to see next, and I'll catch you on the next one. Assalamu alaikum.